the church of just in time, and sometimes a couple minutes later than just in time. So people are still arriving, but we will use this time to make any announcements that you might have for the life of the church. Does anybody have anything they would like to share? Yes, Betsy.
Total joy from yesterday. We had art and blue in the village, and it was booming for the activities. And we're just so excited with so many people being connected. It was a mountain garden full of it, and wow.
So joy for art and bloom, which circulated through the village. And there came to fruition through a lot of hard work from a lot of volunteers, including the people that interpreted paintings as floral arrangements. I think we have one in front of our church right here right now. Did you do that one, Betsy?
Yeah.
Okay, so then if you look again at the art, which is the flowers in front of the narthex, feel free to enjoy the fact that Betsy put it together. It's an interpretation of a painting.
And it's an interpretation by a painting by Linda Gray, who was another church member as well.
Fabulous.
Really good. Well, of course, I didn't bring her painting. All the painting back to my house.
And there were several people that did that. Yes, madame.
I saw two eagles.
Two, okay. Now, I'm going to just say, if anybody else has any wildlife sightings, you need to hold them, because we're going to do a whole, like, wildlife sighting thing as part of our prayer, because that always makes us feel better when we find out what kind of animals we have seen. But I'm putting the eagles down. Any other announcements for the life of the church? Oh, Lori, go for it, sorry.
Okay, I'm going to scold all of them. We need more help in the mornings on Sundays to bring food and to prepare. It seems to me as I walked in today, the same person was doing it again, and I said, why are you doing this? She said, nobody signed up. So guilt is a waste of emotion, and that's what I'm saying. Big and fantastic and famous, but just volunteer and write your name down and write your name down and write your name down so that when we walk in, we're going, oh, who's supposed to do food? I don't know. And seriously, I mean, it's so much fun. Everybody will tell you how wonderful you are.
Just a reminder that the food pantry needs toilet paper and condiments were the two items I was asked to remind you, but they would take anything, so just a reminder.
All right, so just a reminder that the food pantry is continuing to collect items throughout the summer. And we do have families that rely on what they can receive there. Our food pantry is the food pantry for families in Bartlett and Jackson. They cannot go to the Vaughan for their food, right? Because the Vaughan serves the Conway families. So we're their safety net. Any other announcements? Okay, so we're going to do passing of the peace in a slightly different way. And I'm going to invite Gia and Micah to come forward because they actually know what we are about to do.
Taking off my microphone so you don't have to hear me say. All right, guys, come up here. We're going to teach you something, and this is how you're going to do passing of the peace. You can still get up and move around, but we're doing it the way we did it at peace camp. Every single day this week, you know this song, right? I'm turning this off. Okay. You guys are going to sing this back after we sing it to you, all right? I've got peace in my heart. I've got peace in my heart. I've got peace in my heart. And I'll get that kids and they can beat your butt so far, so, you know, you can stand up and actually sing this to each other. The kids all stood up, so.
Thank you.
You'll find in the bulletin a call to worship. Please understand that Jackson is celebrating the 4th of July tonight with fireworks, hence we are actually observing our Independence Day observance today. I use the same word twice in a second so well. May I become at all times a protector for those without protection,
a guard for those who have lost their way,
a ship for those with oceans to cross,
a bridge for those who rivers cross,
a sanctuary for those in danger,
a lamp for those without light,
a place of refuge for those who lack shelter,
and a servant to all in need.
Now will be the time in the service when you're invited to share any prayers of celebration or of concern that you wish to raise up out loud. We will also hold a moment of silence so that those things you can't say out loud may be heard by the one who listens always. Are there any prayers for the life of the village, the valley, the world? May.
I would like us to rejoice in the birth of a granddaughter for Valerie, who's the lady who keeps our church in beautiful shape and nicely clean. She's off giving hugs to her new granddaughter.
So a new baby girl born to Val's daughter, and Val works on our church. Somebody said it double digits. She turned 10. Woo-hoo. Got a couple double digiters here now. So, celebrations for double digits. Go for it. Okay.
Shout out for a most successful First Pride week in the Valley. The number of locals and visitors who were moved by the celebration of diversity was very moving yesterday. And a shout out to our own Reverend Gail for a wonderful Q&A on Friday with the graduates. Thank you.
So, celebration for our first time of creating a place where people can feel recognized and beloved by the Pride Week. Other announcements? I'm sorry, prayers.
Let's not forget our sister church in Zimbabwe.
Thank you. We pray always for our sister church in Zimbabwe, the Chikanga Church in the city of Mutare. And in case you haven't noticed it on the bulletin board, our church, through the plant sale, made a donation that helped to purchase stoves. I'm not sure how many, but a lot of stoves. 30 stoves. They're very simple stoves for families that have been either hurt by the storms or were otherwise in need of something to cook on. And then we have a photo which we'll send out in next month's newsletter of Memory, who is the wife of Edwin Lithuania. So Memory Lithuania was teaching the recipients of the stoves how to use the stoves. So we received some thanks for the stoves and some pictures of them being put to good use. So thank you to everyone for that. There were a couple of prayers raised up at 8 o'clock this morning for Dick and Ben, who are living with depression, and for a young person named Ellery, who was just diagnosed with diabetes at a young age. So different ways that people are feeling challenged in body, mind, and spirit. We pray for all people, regardless of the diagnosis, whether you can see it or you can't see it, whether it's in your bones, your bloodstream, your muscles, or some part of your body, or if it's in your mind, that God will be present to provide healing where that is possible, intervention where that is possible, resilience and dignity, and the love of caregivers and family and friends to support each of us who are challenged along the way. Any final prayers? any other sightings of anything besides we found out that there were two eagles that had recently been seen, right? Yes, Catherine?
We saw our first bear the other day padding across our neighbor's front yard.
Okay, there's a bear in Catherine's neighborhood.
Black bear, not a big one, but mid-sized, nice healthy bear.
I heard from Gloria Hutchings. Oh, go for it. Baby ducks? I think baby ducks and baby geese too. Gia?
A bear crossed our driveway.
Oh boy. There's a lot of bears out right now. A lot of baby geese and ducks. Lots of babies out. Apparently there's a bear snacking on Gloria Hutchings' jacks in the pulpit. They ripped them all out. You have bears in your yard? Jack eating jack in the pulpit. So apparently it's a favorite snack.
The first thing I saw this morning was a bear which is coming down our road. He's there every day.
The daily bear visit. Showing us the meaning of peace in the way that they live and see the world. With gratitude for those who have been with us longest and loved us best, for those that we must say goodbye to, for those that we are accompanying and taking care of in changes in their bodies and their minds, for those who feel lonely, may we give them connection, and may you help us recognize how different people belong to us. With thanks for yellow baby slippers and kingfishers and bears that eat jack in the pulpits, and moose and eagles and baby ducks and baby geese and baby people, for all the ways that the world is good and reminds us to be grateful, and that there is so much here that is alive and full of love and connection. We offer silence now. And we ask that on this day, when we are thinking about freedom, that we appreciate the many freedoms that are ours. Freedom to vote, freedom to speak, freedom to be who we are, to worship as we choose, to use our voices, to write what we think, to stand for what we believe in, to learn, to expect equity in our world. And we think of those who serve in different ways to help create the freedom that we enjoy. The police and the firefighters and the EMTs who are our first responders. The many warriors who are stationed all over the world trying to hold places of peace because they will choose peace over any form of fighting every day of the week. And for we who love them and hold home and the door open for them, O Holy One, hear us as we pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and glory forever. Amen. And as a special surprise, I would invite Jeanette forward to play for her with her voice.
This morning's reading is from Galatians 5, 13, 14, 22, 25. For you are called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for self-indulgence, but through love, become slaves to one another. For the whole law is summed up in a single commandment. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. By contrast, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. If we live by the Spirit,
this message, I wanted to invite anybody that's feeling artistic today that we have glass beads and I have pieces of paper, and if you wish to make a mosaic of peace signs, you can come over here and do that while I'm talking. Because I thought it would be cool. You can do it too, if you'd like. I thought it would be really cool to sort of see what you guys create. We do these things called, you know, like there's mandala paintings that are sometimes done by Zen Buddhist priests. There is an artist that people, the gazebo we're talking about this morning, people paint with sand, and then those things are washed away. So sometimes our art, our ideas, and the greatest things that we create are temporary. And so I thought we would invite our artists to do some work while we are thinking about this message of this morning and be guided again by what they see, knowing that it won't stay, that they are growing, that we are all changing. And so we are always learning, we are always curious, and we always have something to say to each other. The message from Galatians talks about the combination of freedom and serving each other. It talks about the fact that if you have freedom, you could choose to do whatever you want. You could choose to indulge any way you want, but that's not what is asked of you. What is asked of you is to actually cultivate the fruits of the Spirit. To cultivate kindness, compassion, patience, self-discipline, love, forgiveness. Because these are the ways that we live together and try to create a world that celebrates freedom and cultivates freedom for all people, and doesn't need warriors to practice war. We celebrate Independence Day because people went to war for something that they believed in. But even after our country became its own nation, not everybody was free. There were already slaves. Women couldn't vote. Many landowners couldn't vote. There were entire populations that did not yet have the right to speak their minds, to preach, to worship freely, to be who they were. And we are continuing always to work on this idea of freedom, not just in our country, but all over the world. Christ was a political figure. Christ lived to press against oppression, to resist it, to overturn social expectations, to make us see the people that were least visible to others, to raise up their voices when no one else heard them and recognize that what they had to say was important. Our campers learned 5 words this week. I'm going to get Gia and Micah to just kind of tell me words. What's the first one, Micah?
Aloha.
Aloha. Anybody here know what aloha means? Or you think you know what it means? Oh, okay, you got it. Go for it.
Hello.
Hello?
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Any others, Gia?
Welcome.
Welcome. What do you think?
Love.
Love. Those are its meanings. Hello, goodbye, welcome, and love. And the sense of love that is carried in aloha is a sense of place. We want you while you are here to love the people that live here and our islands and our environments. And when you go away again, we want the peace of belonging and love to be planted in your heart, so that you take us with you with compassion and hope. The second word that we learned was shalom. Anybody want to make guesses on that one? Gia?
Hello. Hello.
Peace.
Peace and goodbye. Yes, all three words. That's right. Shalom comes from the Hebrew. And it is said in greeting when people come, shalom, together, or when they are parting, shalom. And we sang it at the camp that Chris and I were deans at up on the mountain at Horton Center, and we sang it together here in this church this week. This church did a lot of things this week, and they were pretty amazing. The third word that we learned. Anybody want to give me that one? Gia. Was a Zulu word. Does that help you? Ubuntu, Micah. Yeah, do you remember what it means? I bet you, say? That's Haiwa. Let's challenge these guys. Let's see, does anybody know what Ubuntu means? I'm just going to throw it out there. Maybe somebody does. Maybe someone will surprise me.
Oh, yeah.
What?
I am because you are, or I am because we are.
It is a word for peace that was used in South Africa during the struggles for apartheid, but it's a more ancient word than that. And it means being in relationship and community. Peace comes from your connection to community, from your sense of belonging, because you cannot be who you are without the other. And the poem that Gia read says that each of the things she named, the snowflakes and the molecules and people, must all exist in community. That in point of fact, there is no reality where you are by yourself. You may feel by yourself. Who doesn't? But we survive and we continue to exist as beings because we are in fact in community. And peace comes from that belonging. Our fourth word this week, that's the one you were going for, Micah. What was that one? Two syllables, Japanese. Gia. Kawa, you got it. Gia, what was that one?
Inner peace and outside.
Inner peace and outer peace. It's two characters that are stitched together. One means inner peace and one means outer peace. You cannot work for peace in the world if you cannot find peace in yourself first. We sat with a yoga teacher and we were silent. We looked into each other's faces. We breathed. We sang the song about breathing. We focused a little bit on what it means to find and hold on to inner peace. Because our outer peace grows from that place, and they are always in tension. And our final word from the Peace and Empowerment Camp, it was a phrase,
si se puede,
means yes.
Yes, we can.
Yes, it's possible. Yes, it could happen. It was started by two people, Cesar Chavez and Dolores Huerta, when they began the farm workers movement in California because they were seeking economic justice for workers who were not well paid and had no benefits, but were the ones that did the work that created wealth for other people. And so they created unions and helped to regularize labor in that industry. It has been used for other purposes since then, but its birth is in Dolores and Cesar Chavez's work. And that was chosen as curriculum that we use on Pine Mountain by the UCC, and we used it again down here to remind us that yes, if you think something is impossible, there is a line in our own scripture that says with God all things are possible. And so this morning at 8 o'clock service, we talked about things that we wish that we could see changed in this valley. We didn't say we were going to change every one of them, but we named things that we felt to be problematic. And at Peace and Empowerment Camp, we talked about the same thing. We talked about what we would dream about and hope for in our world. And so I invite you now, what would you like to see change in this valley? What do you understand to be problematic? that needs to shift in order for there to be a kind of peace for all people and a freedom for all people? Lori?
Tolerance.
Okay, tolerance. Social tolerance. All right. Sam?
Workforce housing.
Housing, that's a really big one.
Economic justice.
Economic justice, so a living wage. We have people that work up to 3 jobs just to try to stay solvent. There are people that are struggling to keep their homes as we speak. There are people that are trying to find jobs.
Healthcare.
Access to healthcare. Not everybody has insurance or access to the same kinds of healthcare. And rural healthcare is overwhelmed sometimes. So it's hard to simply even offer what is needed because there's waiting lists to get in to see counselors or to have a primary care physician. What other things?
Better mental health services.
Better mental health services is a huge one. We have a lot of people living with all kinds of challenges that can't even find the basic supports they need. What other kinds of things? Transportation was named as one today. A lot of people don't own cars, and it's hard to get any place. Yeah.
And patience for those who have cars and are driving around in lots of traffic in summer.
Patience for summer tourists. Traffic snarl. For everybody. For everybody. Patience through our summer because, right, the extra blessing of abundance of people is what keeps this valley going. And yet, Lori Kinsey named the fact that we wanted people to love our nature, and now we're loving it so much that we're actually challenging it, right? That over, apparently on 93, people are parking on the highway to try to get into the national parks. We love our national parks so much that we're overwhelming our national parks. That's both a good and a bad thing, or it's a good and a challenging thing. Anything else that people would like to name? This church was many things this week. This church was a peace camp. This church was a place where we had one challenging conversation where we met the drag queens, and 45 people came to ask questions. We had the courage to ask questions and meet people that we don't ever usually get to meet, who made a lot of us nervous. That's when we met them. At least I say that for myself. This church was also a place where somebody came at about 8:30 at night and banged on the door in the middle of the week. The kids already heard this story at camp. I was working upstairs getting ready for camp the next day. Somebody banged on the door downstairs and then ran upstairs and banged on the upstairs doors. That never happens. Nobody ever bangs on our doors. And somebody banging that hard is pretty desperate. And it was a father with a 2.5-year-old and a partner who had been living in their car for 3 days. They needed some help to keep going. They were trying to get back to Tennessee. They had taken showers up in Randolph at the fire station, and they'd gotten this far, and they needed money for a tank of gas, and they needed food. Well, lucky us, we had our fabulous lunch lady, Sue Kerrigan, who had been cooking every single day for camp, and I had Mexican food and ham, so we fed them plates of Mexican food and ham, and we gave them oranges, and then we sent them with a bag of snacks from camp on their way with a full tank of gas. We were also the canvas for Art in Blue, at least today. We were a place where 2 people said wedding vows. They got married this week, and Bob Parker sang for them, and Alan played for them. We have been so many things this week. And in case anybody's wondering about what's on my cheek, because apparently it looks like stitches, it's not stitches. It's actually a little rainbow temporary tattoo of an origami crane. Because we were giving out peace cranes and temporary tattoos that the clergy in the valley designed together that said beloved, so that all people people would know that they are recognized as children of God. And you could wear it on your arm or your hand or your forehead for a day at least and feel seen and recognized during the Pride event yesterday. The crane, the origami cranes Chris and I created in memory of our daughter years ago, and we still have enough of them to share them now as a form of peace. And if you look in the parish house today, you'll see there's a big strip of cloth that has been filled with peace messages from the people that came and visited the Pride event yesterday. 500 people. In so many different ways, this church has been in service to different populations this week. And we don't all identify with the same populations, but there is a place for each of us to serve others here and outside these walls. And we choose what we're passionate about. There's so many causes that you can take up, but can't possibly take them all up. You pick the ones that make meaning for you. And you stand where you are as a child of God who isn't called to agree with everybody else, but you are called to see that every other person in this valley and in this world is also a child of God, just the way they are. And to recognize them and give them respect, and to stand inside the love that holds you and sees you, and do your best to offer that same love and recognition to others. Freedom isn't something that comes easily. It is a work in progress always. Economic freedom, social freedom, spiritual freedom, political freedom, environmental freedom comes because we work at it. Our children are why you do this work. For the baby ducks and the baby geese and the baby humans that are being born, and the young humans that are learning and teaching and leading. And for me, who have been here a long time, and love this world, and love our families, and want the best for them too, we do not live in singularities. We live in communities. And the words for peace in every language remind us of this. So today, as we watch the fireworks and we give thanks for freedom, let us give thanks for a peaceful freedom. And let us remember that we are called to work for it, for freedom and for peace, for those who come next in this world. Thanks be to God. Please rise for Psalm 532, O beautiful for spacious skies.
Thank you. try to do it with them. Go ahead. So we're going to do the first verse again, okay?
Thank you.
rise for the Doktor and the people. Church painted by children. Peace is lived out by every person in this gathering this morning in the different ways that we have received the fruits of the Spirit and chosen to be of service in this world, even if what we do is make a difference in one life. We ask that you will take what we offer here this morning and put it to your work in the hope of freedom and justice, and love for every person in your world. Amen. So apparently we didn't pick any other closing songs, so I think that means we'd have to sing our peace song again, and then we can go to the benediction. Do you like the peace song? I'm not sure everybody likes it, but you guys, you want to help lead it? I bet the three of you know it by now.
We'll just do the one verse, okay? We'll just do peace. We're not going to make you go crazy. And then we'll do the benediction. Why don't you girls come up front?